He said, you got to understand that your season of death is over. He said, the point you've got to come to in your life. He said, haven't you been in horrible long enough? Come on, somebody. Haven't you been in that crippling place long enough? The spirit of death, Pastor, comes to demobilize you in your mind, praise God. People could be in an anointing atmosphere, but because they've been going through so much dead experience, I'm not talking about physical debt. I'm talking about a spirit of debt that comes, praise God, that sneaks upon you late in the midnight hour, that comes to frustrate you, that comes to seduce you out of your assignment. Tell somebody tonight, I ain't dying right now. I ain't about to give up. There's still a fight in me. He said, you got to get your life to the place where you've already understood that you've already been through everything you could possibly go through. The devil and fling, praise God, his best blow at you. I'm not preaching to anybody tonight. You almost lost your mind. You almost gave up. You almost threw in the towel. If it had not been for the Lord on your side, you would not have even been here tonight. Who am I preaching to in this building? I said, if it had not been for the grace of God. See, the person standing on the side of you have no idea of who you are and what you went through. I'm not talking to anybody. They just think you're an ordinary person. That's why they're looking at you while you shouting up in here tonight. But you got to tell them tonight, say, excuse me, I bear the marks in my body. Say, excuse me, I got some marks on my back. Come on, somebody. You said, Baba Bakosa. You said, Baba Bakosa. You said, Baba Bakosa. Girl, you got to get to the place where you already made up in your mind that after all that you've been through, that you ain't got no more time left to play with the devil. I'm not preaching to anybody tonight. This is the season and the hour. You got to get a Jacob's anointing where you are prepared, praise God, to wrestle all days and all night for your miracles. Am I preaching to any crazy people in this house tonight that has gone into a place where you are prepared to wrestle for your next level anointing? Somebody give God a shout of praise. Say, I'm ready, God. I'm ready, God. I'm ready. He said, Baba Bakasaya. Tell somebody, said, I'm ready. I'm overcoming death. I'm ready to kick death out my life. So what is God saying tonight? He said, you got to get to the place. Even though they say that you are already dead, I'm not preaching to somebody. They already write you off. When Jesus got to the tomb, they had already written Lazarus off. They said, Jesus, he is dead. He is stink. That's what the devil's saying about some of y'all tonight. That you already finished. That you ain't got nothing inside of you. But prophetess declared to us that as long as the word is in us, we can have a divine intervention. As long as the word is in our belly, we can prophesy. Would somebody open your mouth and make a noise in this house? Make a noise, Zion. Let the earth shake. Break the walls down. Make a sound. Let the earth be glad. Let the people rejoice. Jesus. God saying tonight? He said the only way to overcome death is you got to make up in your mind that you're going to refuse to die. I'm not preaching at everybody in this house, because after all they done said about you and after all they done did to you, you're supposed to be dead already. I'm not preaching to anybody. But the Bible said that when Jesus got to Lazarus' tomb, he wasn't trying to make a deal with death. The Bible said he looked dead in the eyes and he said, "Oh death, where is your sting? Oh grave, where is your victory? I am the resurrection. I came to prophesy and declare to you tonight that Jesus is the resurrection, and you shall not die." Give him a shout. So what are you saying tonight? That you gotta come to the place after all the words that have been prophesied unto us in these 3 days, in these several days, that wait a minute, there's been a divine impartation in the name of Jesus. Come on, Jacob, I refuse to let anybody talk me out of my destiny. Come on, Jacob, Rachel is dead, Rebecca is dead, and now they tell you that Joseph is dead. The devil is a liar. But God said that Jacob would have died, but they told Jacob that Joseph is not dead. He's got a place for you in Goshen tonight. Somebody said, "I refuse to die. I'm going to get my blessing."
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Transforming Lives with Apostle Edison and Prophetess Maddie Nottage.
Are you ready to rebuild the altars of prayer in your life? Or are you tired of your dry seasons and ready to experience the power of God like never before? Then Dr. Maddie Nottage is pleased to announce her internationally acclaimed prayer movement, which is taking the nations by storm. This powerful prayer movement is designed to equip, empower, and train up 120,000 intercessors around the world. You can join Dr. Nottage and scores of believers, prayer warriors, and intercessors for a time of strategic prophetic breakthrough prayer on the Life-Changing Prayer Network every Wednesday at 12 noon and the Saturday morning prayer services at 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. To get connected, call 712-432-1699. Access code 514-708-POUND. If you have a prayer request or praise report, call 888-825-7568 or email us at globalprayer@maddienottage.org. If you are in the Bahamas, we welcome you to be a part of our live audience. That's the Dr. Maddie Nottage Prayer Movement. For the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent take it by force.
And now, let's go back into today's program.
Anybody here tonight? So what is God saying tonight? He said the spirit of death comes after the move of God, because what it wants to do, praise God, is to mess with your psyche, to make you believe that all God did over the last several years, over the last several days, was a fake. So what death does, praise God, it begins, praise God, people that are dying begin to have glances, false visions. Come on, somebody, begin to have fake visions. Oh, that's what the devil been trying to do. Give some of y'all some messed up dreams. He's been sending witches in some of your dreams to cause you to realize that, wait a minute, you're gonna die soon. But I came to prophesy again that the devil is a bald face liar, liar. He said, with the spirit of death wants to do, praise God, is convince the people of God that your dreams and your visions have already failed, that you have no more purpose left, that you got no more power left. I'm not preaching anybody tonight. Can I have 2 more minutes of your time? He said the spirit of death will come upon you, praise God, to try to persuade you and to convince you that there's something wrong with you, praise God. And so what begins to happen is when you die, praise God, there's a process called rigor mortis. Am I right tonight? And so what begins to happen, rigor is the aggressive consistency, come on somebody, and the detailed attention that causes, that denotes, praise God, that death has taken place. Rigor mortis, praise God, begins to cause stiffness in your muscles, praise God. The dead cannot speak. So what the devil does is shut the Christian's mouth. You come to a revival, but you got no praise. You come to a revival, but you got no worship. You come to a revival, but you got no power. He said, the spirit of death. Come on, somebody. Work with the spirit of rigor mortis. Mortis means dead. Come on, somebody. In the book of Luke 24 and verse 6, the Bible says that they killed Jesus. They buried him in a tomb. And on the third day, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb looking for Jesus. But he wasn't there. The angel asked Mary, why are you seeking the living amongst the dead? He is risen, as he said. What am I saying tonight? Some of you are looking for a living God in a dead place. Some of you are looking for a powerful God in a dead season. Tell somebody tonight, say, tonight is my night. I am coming out of my place of death. I have been here long enough. The spirit of grief works with the spirit of death. Come on, somebody. Praise God. Come on, that situation already gone. But what the devil will do is have us holding on to a old thing, something that God already promoted out of our life. Can I preach up in this house? He wants to keep us in the valley of sorrow. But David said, yea, do I walk through the valley and the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Somebody said, I ain't dying here. I'm going through this thing. Somebody said, I ain't dying here. Say, I'm going through this thing. Come on, though I go through the valley, as I go through the trial. He said, many are the trials, many are the tests, trial and afflictions of the righteous, but God delivers us out of them all. Am I preaching to anybody? Can I give you a prophecy tonight? You will not die in that thing. Come on, somebody. I told you on this morning, nobody ever walked on water besides Peter and Jesus. Water is something you're supposed to sink in. The very thing that the devil wants you to sink in is the very thing Jesus will cause you to walk on. Tell somebody tonight that I'm not sinking in this thing. I'm not sinking in this stuff. I'm not dying in this place. I'm not going under. Say, this is my hour. I'm going over. I'm going over. To make up in your mind that regardless of come what may in your life, that God has anointed you with a divine purpose, richy purpose, to the intent that is now might be known by the church, the manifold wisdom of God. So what is God trying to say tonight? I want to give you the kind of anointing that will cause kingdoms to be subdued. In the book of Hebrews, the Bible said that these men of God, come on somebody, just for subdued kingdoms, Chapter 2 kingdom. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. They ran through troops. They leaped over walls. I'm not preaching to anybody. You can't just come to a seeker. You gotta seek God to give you power. You can't just come. Resurrection power. I need dunamis power. Come on, somebody. God said, I'm trying to get some power to the church. Praise God. That will cause Hollywood to stop and say, what man of woman is this? Come on. God said, I'm trying to give the church some kind of power that will cause Steven Spielberg to pick up his telephone and start calling you. God said, I will give the church some anointed power, some atomic power, some nitro power. That's going to cause the media news, CNN, ABC, NBC, MSN, to tune in to your stories. Somebody shout power. Praise. Praise. The power's falling to me. The power's falling to me. The power's in the house tonight. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Shabba-ba-ba-ba-ba-shata. La-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-shata. La-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-shata. La-ba-ba-ba-ba-shata.
The Spirit of God continues to move mightily amongst His people.
So God said, what I will do is I will give you an anointing, a power, praise God, that shall defeat every demon that came against your families. Every spirit of insufficiency, every spirit that told you that you will never amount to anything in life. He said, what I will do, daughter, he said, when you travail, you shall bring forth children, says God. Your children shall rise up and call you blessed. Your children shall be set free from every demonic oppression. When they forsake you, I, the Lord, shall bring you out. So hear what the Lord says. I am healing you tonight in your soulical pain. Every soul wound, every soul scar, every hurt, go! But you demon spirit, call infirmity. Tonight we bind you. Every disorder in our blood, every disorder in our system, every disorder in our womb, every disorder in our body, every disorder in our blood, every disorder in our womb. Somebody shall go.